Human development. Developmental tasks defined as arises at a certain period in our life, the successful achievement of which leads to happiness and success, with later tasks, while failure leads to unhappiness, social disapproval, and difficulty with later tasks, by Robert J. Havinghurst. In short, developmental task is the broad jobs of childhood that need to be accomplished in stage in order for children to learn life skills at the appropriate times. Moving forward, let me discuss the 8 stages of development. The process of prenatal development occurs in 3 main stages. The first one is prenatal period. Gestation is development before birth and takes place in 3 stages. The germinal stage begins at the conception when the sperm and egg cell unite in one of the 2 fallopian tubes. The fertilized egg is called the zygote. Embryonic stage. At this point, the mass of cells is now known as the embryo. The beginning of the 3rd week after conception marked the start of the embryonic period, a time when the mass of the cells become distinct as a human. Fetal stage. Once cell differentiation is mostly complete, the embryo enters the next stage and becomes known as fetus. The fetal period of prenatal development marks more important changes in the brain. This period of development begins during the 9th week and lasts until birth. This stage is marked by amazing change and growth. Moving on, the 2nd stage is called infancy. Infancy is what we call to the stage from birth to 2 years old, a time of extreme dependence on adults. In this stage, they learn the first aspect of language, to crawl and possibly walk, and they become familiar with their environment. They tend to develop psychological activities and begin to learn and improve language, symbolic thought, sensory-motor coordination, and social learning. The average newborn infant weighs 3.4 kilograms or 7.5 pounds and is about 51 centimeters or 20 inches long. The newborn gains weight at an average of 170 to 200 grams, 6 to 7 ounces per week. Growth continues, but the rate gradually declines to an average of 60 grams per week after 12 months. Young infants also show a predilection for the tones of their mother's voice, and they manifest as a rising sensitivity to the tones, rhythmic flow, and sounds together make up human speech. Most infants begin crawling between 7 and 10 months, and by 12 months, they can stand up alone. The average baby is able to walk with help by 12 months and can walk unaided by 14 months, at which time he is often referred to as a toddler.
Now let's move to an early childhood, 3 to 5 years. At the early childhood stage, young children learn to become more self-sufficient and to care for themselves, develop school readiness skills, and spend many hours in play with peers. Gross motor development. At this stage, the development skills of the child was characterized into 3, and these are the locomotor skills, non-locomotor skills, and the manipulative skills. Locomotor skills is the skills used by an individual to move from one place to another. These skills include walking, running, and climbing. Non-locomotor skills is a movement in which a body doesn't travel. In other words, it can be performed while staying in the same space. Some examples include bending, stretching, and turning. Manipulative skill is one in which a child handles an object with the hands, feet, or other body parts. Manipulative skills are basic to the development of sports skills, throwing, striking, and bouncing. Parents may identify child's early childhood development characteristics such as the problem, the troublesome, and the toy age. Educators find early childhood development of a child during the preschool age, while psychologists find that this stage of the child is characterized as the pre-gang, the exploratory, or maybe the questioning age.
Middle and late childhood, 6 to 12 years old. At the middle and late childhood, the fundamental skills of 3 R's are mastered. The child is formally exposed to the larger world of its culture. Achievement becomes a more central theme of the child's world of self-control increases. The skills of late childhood can be categorized roughly into 4 major. First, self-help skills. Second, social help skills. Third, school skills. And lastly, play skills. With the presence of parents during middle and late childhood stage, child may be troublesome, sloppy, or quarrelsome age. For educators, they find it during elementary age, and for a psychologist, child may be classified as gang age, age of conformity, and age of creativity. Adolescents, 13 to 18 years old. At this stage of human development, it begins with rapid physical changes, dramatic gains in height and weight, changes in body contour, and the development of sexual characteristics such as enlargement of the breasts, development of pubic and facial hair, deepening of the voice. During adolescent stage, it also pursuit of independence and identity are prominent. Thought is more logical, abstract, and idealistic. Adolescence period also find more time is spent outside of the family. Puberty is the onset of sexual maturity. Gonads, testes in males and ovaries in females to initiate a growth spurt. Testosterone for male. Changes or growth of the testes and the scrotum, penis and first pubic hair, the capacity of ejaculation, the growth spurt, voice change, facial hair development or beard. Growth and continuing growth of pubic hair. Estrogen for female. Beginning of breast enlargement, the appearance of pubic hair, the widening of the hips, a growth spurt, menarche, first menstruation.
Now let us know about the six stages of human development, which is the early adulthood. In this stage, it is said that the physical development and maturation of people ages 19 to 29 years old is complete. Humans in this stage accomplish their many responsibilities, including finding home or settling down, establishing family or circle of friends, and getting a good job. This stage also includes the time wherein humans are most likely to experience aging problems such as changes in skin, vision, and reproductive capability. When it comes to their emotion, a person's undergoing early adulthood stage are experiencing emotional tension that may occur when they encounter any event or thought that made them feel frustrated, angry, or nervous. Early adulthood is also the time of social isolation. Social isolation is when there is an absence of social interaction, contacts, and relationships with family and friends, with neighbors, or in the community. This stage also shows the signs of dependency, of value changes, of creativity, and of the adjustment to a new life pattern, because people undergoing early adulthood are adapting and learning from their surrounding, little by little, because it is the time when they already know what is the right decision that will make their life easier.
Well, let's proceed to the seventh stage of human development, also known as the middle adulthood. People ages 30 to 60 years old are undergoing to what we call middle adulthood. This is the time when a person expanded his or her personal and social involvement and responsibility. One of the good examples for social involvement and responsibility of a person's undergoing middle adulthood is when they use their experiences in life to assist young generations to have a productive life and to be a competent individual. Midlife may also be the peak time of earning and spending to meet the demands of launching children or caring for aging parents. When it comes to their health, the most common health problems experienced during middle adulthood are the changes in vision, hearing, more joint pain, weight gain, and other serious diseases such as arthritis, heart disease, diabetes, stroke, mental disorders, and etc. It is also the stage wherein they develop some level of expertise in things that are personally meaningful to them.
Now we are down to the last stage of human development, which is the late adulthood. The stage of life from 61 years old and above is what we call late adulthood. In this stage, the aging process generally results to faster changes in the physical, cognitive, and social capabilities and needs. This is the time when a person undergoing late adulthood may experience a decreasing strength and health. According to Dr. Thomas Armstrong, those with long lives have acquired a rich repository of experiences that they can use to help guide others. Elders thus represent the source of wisdom that
exists in each of us, helping us to avoid the mistakes of the past while reaping the benefits of life's lessons. The major transition in this stage is the retirement. They chose to retire because of these two things. They want to experience leisurely life or because they prioritizing and considering their health. The stage of late adulthood can also change their social roles. We all know that elderly spend their life working and serving the community. But now they are the one who needs an attention because as time goes by, they experiencing lack of energy and inability to perform tasks and the fact that they are vulnerable to some kind of illness and diseases.